Hey everybody, Dan the Wolfman here, and today I'm hoping to answer the age-old question, does size really matter? Men throughout millennium have been saying, oh, come on, size doesn't really matter. But if you ask 100 women, I don't know, does size really matter for today's modern CCW EDC carry? So hopefully today I'm going to be able to answer that between this micro-compact that everyone's starting to carry nowadays versus a more fullish size or a compact with a long barrel, fullish size pistol. I picked these because this is the lightest striker and the heaviest striker, biggest one, the smallest and the biggest one that I own. This is my backup gun every day. It is carried as a backup gun, and occasionally it is the only gun on me when you go to certain places. Usually I'll have something like this primary. And also the reason I'm going to be comparing these today is at least for the first couple weeks here until I get a new holster in, hopefully from Dara Holster will send me one. This is going to be my arm guard duty weapon. Okay, so I'll be able to compare how much accuracy, speed, and everything does it really make a difference. And is that difference important enough for most people? What's most important, if you've got something like this or even bigger, a double action heavier pistol, this is 18.4 ounces, this is 26 ounces, and I picked this also because a lot of people do carry that 25 to 26 ounce compact 9mm striker fired pistol. So these are good representations of a current micro pistol and a current kind of compact or even longer barrel. Does barrel length and sight radius matter? 3.2 inch versus 5 inch. Does that really matter? Guys, please look at my full unboxing of the Ruger Max 9 Pro. I find it a very excellent pocket pistol. You can put the smaller mag in when you really need that deeper concealment. Right now I've been carrying it with the bigger magazine, and that's how I will be carrying it. So I will be able to compare hits from full size grip to full size grip. Okay. So obviously physics matters, meaning that heavier weight should give better recoil management. This has probably the best striker fired trigger that there is, other than the best striker fired pistol you don't know about video that you should go check out that I filmed. And most people aren't even aware that pistol exists. So besides that, this is empty, considered one of the best striker fired pistols with a nice short rapid reset right there. Now, people don't really like the way this feels. I don't like to dry fire this one a bit, empty fire, but here's my take up. But when actually rapid firing at the range and multiple target scenarios that you're going to see, I find this trigger to be just fine. People that complain about triggers generally can't shoot very well. They can't shoot different platforms very well. So does it really matter? Is it going to matter? Is it going to matter to a civilian? No. Would it matter to law enforcement? Absolutely. Law enforcement has to engage at far greater distances on a much higher percentage. Let's look at Tom Givens. Out of 67 incidences of his students, 3 died because they were not carrying. And that's the first rule of gunfighting is ABC, always be carrying. So if you're not going to carry something like this or a bigger, heavier Beretta or SIG or a hammer-fired gun or something, have this, and that's going to handle the biggest preponderance of civilian self-defense, defensive gun use needs. 3 died because they weren't carrying. Everyone else survived and no legal trouble. 87% were in the 3 to 5 yard range. 3 to 5 yards. So from 3 to 5 yards, I'm guessing this is almost just as good as this, and we're going to put it to the test. I'm going to do different drills. For the preponderance, I actually like something waistband carried for something in between what this is a pocket carry to me, though I will work from an inside waistband toaster holster today, which you can get a discount with using code Dan the Wolfman. And I'll be using a duty style almost-ish 3 o'clock holster for this because that's what I gotta train on right now. until I get a new holster in. 4% of his students had to engage from 15 to 25 yards. 4%. 4% were 0 to 2 yards. Now, those are more switched on, people being very aware, but 4% were the 15 to 25 yard range. So once we get 15 to 25 yards, do I think I can hit with this as good as this? I really doubt it, but that is up to a shooter's skill. I definitely want to be able to hit good with this out to 12 yards for sure. But past 15 yards, there's only so much you can probably do. Can you hit as good as this? No. And so if you want to be prepared for those outlier incidences or third-party rescue, or like Paul Harrell talked about in his active shooter mass, I'm going to use the quote right there, mass number 3 video the other day, can you do far better with a full size, he was using a Beretta versus a Chiefs Special, a J-frame? Yeah, absolutely. Now, he is a very experienced marksman. He can still shoot that pretty well out to 25 yards. Can most people shoot something this small or a snubby revolver out to 25 yards? No, they really can't, but I'm going to put it to the test. I'm a pretty good shooter. I've gone through SWAT school. I'm an armed guard. So let's find out, does size really matter? Now, ballistics does matter. This is still good enough with a 124 plus PHST. This is still pretty good with just about any ammo when you have a longer barrel. And I like a 124 plus P or a 124 plus P plus. You're getting really good, almost 357 Magnum velocities. Does that make a difference in stopping power? Yeah, and the preponderance of civilian gun use, defensive gun use, no. It's close range, 3 to 5 yards, because it's either a robbery or sexual assault, and they kind of come up towards you and test you to see your reactions. Outside that 3 yards is most people's like, hey, what are you doing? So would it make a difference for most situations, civilian defensive gun use? Probably not, but definitely law enforcement, I want that 5-inch 124 plus P or 124 plus P plus, depending on the bullet and your situational needs. I want that much higher velocity, or I want a 45. But hey, that's another story. So anyway, guys, what do you think? Ask your girlfriends, does size really matter, or will this get it done? Let me know in the comments below.